Hello, I'm Dr. Dennis McKenna. I am joined today by Mr. Charles Day, Vice President of Security Services at Albany Med.
Indeed.
Welcome, Charles.
Thank you for having me.
Well, I'm so glad you're here. We're going to talk a lot about security in just a minute. Today is Tuesday, September 15th, giving you the update from Albany Medical Center. So, Charles, we normally begin by talking about some COVID numbers, so let me do that first. First graph, Capital Region, people in the eight counties being treated for COVID-19. That number now is 25, and you can see that number is definitely still on the lower side. Next graph here is admissions and discharges to Albany Medical Center. And what you can see, and we've been talking about this now for a couple weeks, okay, is that there are many days with discharges, sometimes one or two, and many days without admissions. And so this continues to be a very positive trend. But the next graph, this is really the most exciting one, Charles. So currently, this morning, here at Albany Medical Center, the number of people in the hospital that we're treating for COVID-19 is five.
Wow.
Five. And that is actually the lowest number in 6 months.
That's
6 months. So at one point, we were as high as 80. But you have to go back to the beginning of March to have a number as low as five. So things continue to move in a very positive direction here on this campus. Obviously, we're not going to take our eye off the ball. We're very focused on this, and we're preparing for how to deal with COVID and flu at the same time, and we're going to talk more about that in the future. Dr. Venditti normally plays this role, so this week I'll fill in for him. Travel advisory, we know the governor each week announces states that are coming on and off the travel advisory list. So more good news today. There are six states coming off the list. They are California, Hawaii, Maryland, Minnesota, Nevada, Ohio, off the list. So people can travel to those states and they don't need to undergo the travel advisory. But the states that are still on the list, they come through if they're an employee and get checked here before they come back to work. And we've talked about that before. All right, last item before we talk about security. Blood drive is today and tomorrow. Today it's from 1 to 6 p.m. and tomorrow it's from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. and that's in F309. I'll be giving blood today. I know if Dr. Venditti was here, he would talk about how he gives blood, so I'll have to give an extra pint just for him today.
I'll try to fill in.
Yeah, you can fill in.
I'll fill in.
How
about I got it?
Yes. 262-3491 is the volunteer office if you want to go ahead and give them a call. Really important. We have a trauma program here. We give a lot of blood products on this campus. This is another way our workforce can give back. Okay, now, the most important thing, Mr. Charles Day, you took over for Mr. Heritage.
Yes, I did.
And he was here for about 25 years.
Yep.
And you've been at Albany Medical Center for how long?
9 years.
9 years. Tell us a little bit about your background. Where did you come from?
Where did I come from? All right. I started.
State trooper.
I'm a state trooper. I was born on Long Island, became a trooper in the 80s, late 80s. We'll go there. And
you rose up to the pretty high rank
to major,
in the state.
I was retired as a major in state police, and I retired after 21 years. Went from Long Island to Plattsburgh. Well, in between, I was in college in North Carolina, so it was quite the change.
Mr. Heritage also was a state trooper.
Yes, he was.
And
yes,
you
he
were
was.
As well. So he brought you into the organization
he did,
here.
He did.
And you've risen up the ranks, and you've been in charge of the security services now for how long?
For about a year. Mr. Heritage retired last year and had a great celebration for him.
And yeah, for sure.
Yeah,
and we miss him. If he's watching, hello to Mr. Heritage.
Oh, indeed.
We've talked in the past about how this campus is about as large as a small country, the Vatican City.
Yes,
and the men and women of your security services department actually are responsible for keeping that entire place safe.
Yes.
Talk about those very important men and women.
First, couldn't do it without our security team.
Yes.
And without the support of the leadership team. So I thank
right.
you for that.
Thank
and always
you.
For, and, you know, and when we go to Vatican City, I saw a number that they have, and we're comparable because I don't want to comment on the number of security. You taught me that, you know, so we don't comment on security because, you know, that would be almost a breakdown of security.
But we have a
mission.
Safe number of people.
We have a safe number, just like
for
the Vatican.
Sure. Right.
Nothing's ever happened at the Vatican.
Very good.
We're keeping it safe here as well.
And at the beginning of the pandemic with COVID,
right.
the security department had to re-engineer the way in which it did work on this campus as far as, you know, visitor restrictions and stuff. Talk about the process you and your team went through to try to change things so quickly.
Right. We're constantly performing risk assessments
mm-hmm.
and trying to see where there might be a vulnerability and trying to mitigate any
right.
vulnerabilities that there might be.
Right.
So during the pandemic, we saw that you had to reduce the number of entrances and the right. number of areas where possible. I know it's very important that patients have visitors come to see them,
right.
so that helps them to heal.
Right.
And so we tried to do all that we could, and then when the initial pilot program came about with the visitors,
right.
and we started with an hour, and now we're at a little more time, and it's 4 hours now, and we try to get everybody in here as quick as possible, because I know it's very important that patients have their family members near them.
For sure. And as I like to say, the security team is responsible not only for our safety
yep.
of our workforce and also our visitors, but in many ways they're the first face you see when you come on campus, and they're often the last face you see as you leave. And so they're as much part of the patient experience as people at the bedside. And I know that's important to you. You talk a lot about how important it is that they be a friendly face
Indeed.
And a helpful face in addition to keeping the campus safe.
Right. Well, As Mr. Heritage said, he always stressed that he wanted security to be more ambassadors.
Right.
So they are the first people. They're the ones that are going to greet you. They're the person that you're going to see first. That's who you're going to encounter. So I want to keep them well informed, make sure they have all the training that they could possibly have, and just make sure you have a positive experience, right.
As you know, I work down in the emergency
yes,
department
you do.
As well. And for many years, I've worked alongside our security men and women, and I think they do a remarkable job keeping us very safe. And I've seen the way in which they handle difficult situations in a very professional manner. I think that speaks a lot to you and your leadership. I think you have a couple quotes that you've heard in the past that define a little bit about the security team here and their mission.
No, indeed. And I'll start off with the first quote, and this is from our CFO, COO, Fran Albert. And it was, safety does not happen by accident. It is a 24/7 discipline. Our workforce is our most valuable asset. The community, patients, and students are the lives we have dedicated ourselves to serve. Albany Med is a safe place to work, to learn, to visit, and to receive care. And then, as a man of your work, this is from Dr. McKenna, Albany Med is a safe place to get care. Very succinct, and we're going to keep it. He's a man of his word, and every time you've said anything, you've always kept your word.
Thank you.
I will make sure you continue to, Albany Med is a safe place to get care. We'll make sure we keep it that way.
Thank you. And it's a safe place as far as the care that's delivered, but it's safe because of the environment that your professionals create for us. Charles, one of the things that a couple people have asked me recently is, during COVID, we've narrowed down the number of entrances into the hospital as a way of controlling access. The weather is starting to turn a little bit. It might be getting colder in the next couple months or so. Anything you can tell us about whether or not we're going to be able to change up entrances into the hospital?
No, indeed. Been working with a security manager, with Steve Riley and Angela Lessie, trying to ensure that we can, we're looking at some things. Right now, we hear everyone,
right.
We'll bring recommendations to the cabinet,
okay.
see what we can do. And, this will be my last Mr. Heritage quote. It's where security and convenience don't always go together.
Yes.
And I want to make sure you're secure first. And, whatever we can do to make it more convenient, but your safety and security comes first before
okay.
anything else.
So you're studying the
I'm
issue.
I'm studying the
and
issue,
you're
and I will bring
recommendations
to you. Yes, sir.
All right. Very good. Anything else you'd like to tell us about yourself, your team?
Well, a couple things. Next week, September 20th through the 26th, is National Security Officer Appreciation Week.
Excellent.
So it's something, maybe I don't even say thanks to the team. Couldn't do it without the team.
For sure.
It's not my operation. We need them.
For sure.
And it's where if you see the dedication and you see them on post and you see them, they've been here throughout the whole,
right.
COVID crisis, the pandemic. And without fail, we've been able to keep it secure and safe. And there were still people still coming to get care.
Yes.
And it didn't have to do, it wasn't with COVID because we served, the bigger community. So
that week is coming up. So we'll celebrate that as
well. September 20th through the 26th. And also, and this is something, I mean, just the opportunity that you've provided, you know, at Albany Med has provided as far as working with the community and not-for-profits. March the 5th, you were an MC at Double H Ranch, and I was there.
Yeah.
So, you know, I got to see you up there in your, you know, in as a MC, so yes. Did a great job.
Thank you.
And an organization I'm involved with, Sigma Pi Phi Fraternity, and it's a Beta Psi Boule, which is in Albany, New York. We have an opportunity to work with the Double H Ranch, so I brought another group of people up there.
Nice.
To see. This is truly a transformation. People say Disney, I won't do any commercials, but Disney World is the greatest place on earth. I'm looking at the Double H Ranch. I came back, and as much as I was talking about it, they're like, okay, you're going to move? I was like,
right.
Yeah, I'll commute from there. It was just like a great place. And I mean, as I was a trooper in the Adirondacks, it just didn't, that was the most beautiful place that you've seen, and just knowing that the lives are touched.
So for those who don't know, Double H Ranch, a camp for children with medically qualifying conditions. The medical center often provides physicians, nurses, respiratory therapists to go up and volunteer up there.
Yep.
You got connected, and now you're up there, you're interested. You were interested in sickle cell disease, and
yep.
You were talking about using your fraternal organization to support camp. And I just want to thank you for your leadership.
Indeed.
That's
indeed.
Wonderful.
Indeed, and I mean, it's sickle cell anemia month, September
right.
of this month. And, you know, I saw that they had 223 campers that they served that
yes.
are afflicted or have sickle yeah. cell disease. So it's just like a great
synergy.
Yeah, great synergy that we could bring together, like serendipity meeting. You know, this opportunity is coming up, and I know how supportive Albany Med
yes.
is of, you know, and this is a commercial kind of, because it's like I feel this strongly. Double H Ranch is having a gather around the virtual campfire September 26th. So go online and be Albany Med.
Thank
it's like
you.
That's what we do. We support our community all the time.
Thank you, Charles, for talking about Double H. Obviously, it's very important to me. There's another area that you're also involved with, the George Biddle Kelly Foundation. Talk
Indeed.
A little bit about that.
Okay. I know you went to Cornell University
yes.
in Ithaca, New York. I'm also a member of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated, which was founded in 1906 at Cornell University. One of its founders, George Biddle Kelly, was born in Troy, New York. And we've been working with the foundation to look at the digital divide. And wow. with Spectrum and with the support of Albany Med, you know, we've been able to help some of the students get past that digital divide, because everyone doesn't have the same access.
Yes.
You know, and so
that's
all the
incredibly
help, yeah.
important today
indeed,
with COVID.
Indeed. It with COVID and with virtual
remote
learning, you know, and I think that's something that we have to be aware of, that everyone's not as fortunate as we are, and you know, in this community, and that's.
And you're involved with that as well.
I'm very much involved, and Albany Med has been
yes.
involved and has been very supportive of this foundation and helped raise a lot of money.
Good.
And you know, we're just moving forward and making sure everyone has an opportunity to succeed.
Well, we're glad that you're using this platform to talk about that, because it's very important. And thank you for your work with that.
Yep.
You do a lot of great work here. You do a lot of great work outside
no,
here, so thank you
so much.
A great leader and a great friend. Thank you for
yes.
joining us.
Thank
we'll
you.
We'll hope to have you back again, and thanks you to your team for
All
everything
right.
they do, for sure.
All right, thanks.
All right, good. We'll be back again on Thursday with another update from this campus. We once again ask that you please take care of yourself, take care of each other, and we'll see you in 2 days.